guys, I'm Sushmita from Miss Pink Shoes and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be talking about my January faves and nays. So, Jan has not at all been a good month. I was so excited for this year. I was really looking forward to 2018. I started this year with such a good mood and good spirit and it just all fell apart and it took me down with it. Jan was like really bad. Like, I cannot talk about it much because it's really personal and I went through a lot of things. I'm not ready to talk about it yet, but yes, it was a terrible month and I'm sorry I was away last week. I might be a little irregular this month also because there's just a lot happening and I need to concentrate on a lot of other things as well. But yes, I will try my best to be as regular as I can, so I'm extremely sorry. I apologize, but I really hope you guys understand and you support me through this because it's one of the toughest phases of my life right now. So yes, I'm not feeling too well, so I might not be as energetic as I have in the other videos, but I'll try my best to keep up. So yes, with all of that kept aside, I did try a lot of products. I do love some of them and I have a lot of amazing recommendations for you. So yes, if you guys would like to know my faves and nays for the month of Jan, then please keep on watching. So, a little disclaimer, there are going to be a lot of lip colors in this, but that's because I tried so many lip colors this month and all of them worked out beautifully. So yes, talking about my first favorite for this month have to be the Garnier Micellar Water. This is their oil infused version. I also have the original Micellar Cleansing Water, which is like a water-based one. So I absolutely love them, but especially this one, oh my god, is amazing. So I got these bottles in the PR, but before I received them itself, I bought them and I'd finished one bottle of each, so I know how they work. I like this a lot, but this has just stolen my heart because this removes my makeup so freaking well. Like, it has oil mixed in it. Once it settles down, there'll be water till here and there'll be a small layer of oil. So you're supposed to mix it and put it on a cotton and keep it on your face, press it for a few seconds and just swipe it off. And this removes your makeup to perfection. I will have a video up on my Insta tomorrow or by day after, so you guys can go have a look how this removes the makeup. But yes, this is so freaking good when it comes to removing waterproof makeup, non-waterproof, anything you have in your face, glitter, shimmer, lash glue, it removes everything really well. Totally recommend this to you guys, one of the best makeup removers out there in the market. My next favorite for this month is the lip color that I'm wearing right now. It's the Lakme Absolute Lip Pout Matte, which was their collaboration with Masaba Gupta. And this is in the shade Cherry Bite. So I did pick up one more shade, which is also really pretty. But this is something that I've been wearing so much. I absolutely love this color, but the color is not the show stealer. I think the formula is just amazing. It's so on point. I have tried almost every lipstick that Lakme has put out in the crayon form, like their crayon lip colors. And this by far has been the best formulation. I do not think they put this out before. There was something similar to this, but it was not as good as this one. This just has my heart to it. It works so well. It's really rich matte lip color that stays on for such a long time. It gives such a beautiful texture to your lips and I just love the sensation of this on my lips. Like, my lips are so comfortable but at the same time so freaking matte, and this is one of the best crayon lip colors that I've tried. I really like this. Although this collaboration is slightly pricey, the products are on the pricier side, it's totally worth the money. So just go to a Health & Glow or any store near you, try out the shades and buy. I'm sure you're gonna want this because this is just amazing. My next favorite lip color for this month is the Wet n Wild Catsuit Liquid Lipstick in the shade Give Me Mocha. So I ordered like 3 shades from this range and all of them are amazing, but this shade particularly is so freaking gorgeous. It's like my go-to color right now. It's kind of like an MLBB shade for me and I love it. The formula is great. It's an extreme matte liquid lipstick which dries completely matte, but it does not make your lips look dry, which I love. It's really comfortable on the lips, stays on for a good amount of time, and the shade is just gorgeous. It's one of those colors that would flatter a lot of Indian skin tones, and the price point is also great. Like, it's for 500 bucks if I'm not wrong, I'm not quite sure, but yeah, it's totally worth the money. And if you want to buy a liquid lipstick, you don't want to spend too much, this is the one to go for. Although the shade range is slightly disappointing, they have 6 shades I believe in India, and out of the 3 shades are catering only to fairer skin tone. They will wash out the darker skin tone, so the shade range is a bit of a bummer. But the formulation and the texture and the shades that are there are beautiful. My next favorite for the month is the foundation that I mixed and I made. I've made a video on this and I'll link it on top in case you guys haven't seen it. So basically, I took all my foundations and BBCC creams and mixed them together and created this foundation. And it just works so freaking well. Like when I made the video, I liked it so much. But I didn't know that I would love it this much. It's the one that I'm wearing right now. It's the one that I've been wearing for all of my recent shoots. I've done a couple of photo shoots over the last, 2 to 3 weeks after I shot that video. And it has just worked so well. My skin looks freaking flawless. I don't need to conceal anywhere. I don't need to go over the second layer. And it just stays on my face for such a long time. Like I go out in the hot sun and shoot and sweat. And I just have to dab it with a tissue and everything just goes off except for my makeup. Like all of the sweat and the dirt goes off and my makeup just stays in place. It makes my skin look so flawless, but it does not look cakey. Like it does not look cakey at all. The shade is bang on and everything about it is just perfect. I'm almost out of it. Like I have only enough left for one more use. So I'm definitely gonna mix all my foundations again into this container because it just works really well. I don't know how, I don't know why. Maybe it's the goodness from everything together, I don't know, but it just looks freaking amazing. Like my skin actually has trouble right now. I have acne scars and I have a lot of redness and everything just looks so even and nice and flawless and I love this. The next two favorites are from the brand Technique. This was sent to me by online makeup store. It's a page on Instagram. If you don't know, I have collaborated with them in the past to try out and review their products. And these two really stood out for me this month. Actually, I have one more from it. I'll show you guys in just a bit. So this is the Super Fine Matte Press Powder. And this is in the shade Biscuit. And this is such a nice compact. Like the texture is, oh my God, so freaking soft. Like your hand is just gonna melt into this. It's just such a soft texture. And although it looks like it's really fair, when I put it on, somehow it's just fine. It sets my makeup in really well. It does not look too powdery. It just melts into your foundation and sets it in place. And it just keeps it there for a really long time. And when you use this solo, it does not give you too much coverage, but it definitely helps in oil control and just basically evening out your skin tone. So this is a really good compact. I was pretty surprised when I tried this. I thought it was going to be too fair. And when I tried it on my hand also it was really smooth. I felt like it might look powdery, but it didn't do any of that, and this is a really good compact and I'm so impressed with it. The next is their Soft Focus Transparent Loose Powder. Guys, this is such a beautiful setting powder. It is so finely milled, like it's so fine. Like I just take that much on my finger and I do that and it's gone. Like it's so soft and it just melts into my skin, especially when I bake my face with it and set my concealer and any other place which requires extra setting. This does such a beautiful job. It has slight brightness to it. Like you can't use this on your entire face because it will make your face a little brighter. But for highlighting, this is amazing. For baking, this is amazing. It's a really good loose powder. I think it's one of the best that I've tried. I love my Kryolan one. Like I cannot get enough of the Kryolan loose powder, but I think this is better than that and it's totally worth the buy. My next favorite is again from Technique. It's their Chunky Lip Liners. So I don't really use lip liners because I don't see the point in it. I find it like an extra investment and spending extra money. But this was sent over to me, so I tried this out and it comes in a set of 5, but I have 3 shades to show you guys right now. This is a really good formula to start out with. This is the shade Coral. So this has an amazing formula. It's really smooth. You don't have to like drag it onto your lips. If your lips are extremely dry, then yes, it is going to feel a little draggy on your lips, but if you have normal lips, it will work amazingly. It stays on for such a long time. I wore this on New Year's Eve. I wore the red color and I slept and woke up and I still had a perfect red pout. Throughout the night, I had a perfect red pout. It just stayed on my lips forever. It's an extreme matte formulation. It's extremely matte, but it does not dry out your lips at all. So that's a good thing. And it's really comfortable to wear. It stays on for a good amount of time. It's not too expensive. And the shade range is also really good. So these are my 3 favorite shades from the set of 5. This is called Coral. This is Bright Pink. And this is Bright Red. So the red is a really nice blue tone red, which will make your teeth look whiter, flatters Indian skin tone so well. And it's like a really nice bright in your face red. Same goes with the pink. It's really bright, really in your face. And the shade Coral is something which is more for the fairer skin tone. If you're on the deeper skin tone, this might wash you out, but nevertheless it's a beautiful shade. So I've been using these 3 lip colors a lot along with the other lip colors that I've been using. Great formulation, totally worth the buy. Alright, coming to my last two favorites. This is from the Maybelline x Gigi Hadid collaboration. So this is the lip color, which is in the shade Austin. In my review itself, I told you guys how much I love this. This is such a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful red lip color, guys. I cannot get over how stunning the color is. And more than that, the formulation, it's just so comfortable on the lips. This is obviously not as long lasting as the Lakme one or the Technique ones, but this gives such a beautiful tint on your lips even after it's faded. So that's a good thing. The shade is gorgeous. It's really comfortable on your lips, and I have been using this a lot. Like, in comparison to the Technique Red, I've been using this more. If you're looking for a good red lip color to buy, I would totally recommend this, and it's otherwise also really worth the money. My last favorite is the brow pencil in the shade dark brown, which is from the Maybelline x Gigi range. So this is such a great product. When I reviewed it, I liked it, but I didn't realize that I would love it this much. After I've been using it for a couple of times, I just can't get enough of this. It's what I've used on my brows today. It's something that I've been using on my brows almost every single day or every other day. It has such a nice waxy consistency that, I don't know, it just works really well for me. It's not the most pigmented product. This is the swatch right here. It's not extremely pigmented, and I mentioned this in my review also. If you have a lot of visible gaps that you're looking to fill, this will not work for you. But if you're somebody with normal brows who just wants to fill them in and define them, you are gonna love this. This is such an amazing product. I feel like I didn't talk about this enough in the review, and I'm glad I have this chance because this is such a beautiful product. It's one of the best brow products I've tried. I can definitely say that. Maybelline has never disappointed me with a brow product, so I wasn't surprised. But yes, this is so amazing. Again, totally recommend it. Alright, now coming to the May for this month, the only product that did not work out for me, and for a very silly reason, is from the Gigi Hadid Maybelline range. Like, it's so weird, I have one of the shades as a favorite, but the other shade is a nay. This is the shade Tora, and let me just swatch it for you guys. So this is what the swatch looks like. It might work for a lot of skin tones out there. Not saying that it's a bad shade, but it's not a good shade for me. It washed me out completely. And I tried mixing this with other lip colors to like lighten them or whatever. And I don't know, it just didn't do a really good job. I don't know why. When I mixed it with other formulas, it just didn't work. And I don't really know if I'll be able to make too much use out of this, because this just washed me out completely. And I don't think anyone in my home also would really like to wear this color because it's just too light. So yeah, just for the shade, this is a nay for me. So guys, that was it for this video. I really hope you guys liked it. And if you did, don't forget to give this video a huge thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel, the link is down below. You can also follow me on my Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat and Twitter. All the links are given in the bottom bar. And I'll see you soon in my next video. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Bye.